So we've now achieved our 40 averages and we have our FRF. Now, if you look at it, it did smooth out more and more as we got more averages. But even at 40 averages, you can still see that the FRF isn't quite that smooth for any of these modes. Now, what's the issue then? Well, if we go back to our MIMO FRF setup, you'll see we chose a continuous random signal type. And for conditioning, we went with the uniform window, which basically means no window. So basically, our FRF is suffering from leakage because we don't have a periodic signal. Now, what we could do is simply use a Hanning window on our reference and response, and that would improve our FRF, make it more smooth. But another option is to make the signal itself periodic. And how we can do that is using burst random. So we'll change both output one and output two signal types to burst random. We'll change our mode to burst. And we'll keep the windows at uniform. And we'll increase our level here to match our pass measurement of 0.2 volts. And go back to measure. Arm the system. Hit start. Now, right off the bat, we can see that our FRFs are much smoother because we have a periodic signal. It's zero at the beginning and it's zero at the end because the signal actually turns off. So let's take 40 averages and compare. So now we have our 40 averages, and we look at our FRF now, and it is certainly much smoother at each mode in comparison to our continuous random that didn't have a window. So those are some of the basic steps to performing your first MIMO FRF test.